light. Breathe in, leave it all behind. I just wanna see the light. Even if it makes me blind, I just wanna see the light. Breathe in, leave it all behind. I just wanna see the
Hey guys, it's TheHunterG. I just want to welcome all you guys back to the channel. But this video is going to be a little bit different. Just got out of classes, and I've been really stressed out lately. So I figured, you know, I'm going to go to like the local state park here in Williamsport. It's Susquehanna State Park, and it's right next to the Susquehanna River. It's just calm, and it's just nice to be around. This is my first time here, but I can tell I want to be here a lot more often. But really, today I want to showcase my car. I'm not going to do a full-on review on it. I'm not going to do a review. I feel like since it's my car, I'm going to have a biased opinion because I obviously really like it. So what I'm going to do is, me and a friend of mine, Layton Cook, he has his own channel. I'm going to link it in the description. What we're planning on doing is we're going to do like a swap review type of thing. He's going to take the Trans Am out, and I'm going to take out one of his cars. I don't know if it's going to be the 300Z or the Audi. We're just going to swap, and we're going to do like a collaboration review on it. But today, instead of just doing a review, because I really do want to showcase my car, and I haven't yet. So what I'm going to do is do like a top five things I dislike about the car. And then top five things I like about the car. All right, I'm gonna do the dislikes first because everyone wants to get the badge out of the way, right? So I'm gonna cut to that now. All right, I'm gonna start in the car. The first thing I do not like about my 1998 Pontiac Trans Am is the shifting. This is the first car I ever learned how to drive a manual in. And right away, this car came stock with a Hurst short throw package. But the throws are not short, really. I mean, I've been in cars that the throws are a lot longer, but they are definitely not short by any means. They make a lot of different short throw kits for it because obviously it's not a short throw. But also learning it, the way the short throw is set up, you have like first gear, second gear, and then what I tell people is a lot of people that drive this car are gonna go straight up into fifth because the spacing in it is just so close compared to like the throws. The throws are really long, but then like the spacing in between the like first and third gear is like close to nothing. Like I basically tell people when they want to learn drive this car, is they're going to second, and then they're basically going straight back up into third. It's almost like in a diagonal type of motion. And that actually kind of sucks because I'm so used to that, and honestly, I blew out my clutch. Last year, I think it was in October. No, it was last summer. Yeah, it was sometime last summer. And I was going on the highway. I was in first. You know, and getting on the highway, I shifted the second. I was letting it rev out a bit, and I wanted to shift into third, and I went straight back into first, and totally ripped out my clutch. I had to put a new replacement clutch in it. But it's just that small. I couldn't tell I was back in first. So rest in peace that clutch. When I did that, I actually think I fucked up my transmission as well, which is gonna lead me into the next thing I don't like. Is when I'm driving, I'm not going to be able to record it, but for a lot of people, it happens in third, like when you're going from second, especially when the transmission's really cold, when you're going up to second, it grinds going in,
But it grinds a lot going into fourth. I don't know what it is. It happened right after I put the clutch in. I've been told it's a synchro. I've been told it's bad transmission fluid. I don't know. But I'm end up going to do a transmission rebuild on this thing eventually. But I'm just going to keep on driving it until it grenades itself, honestly. It's not too bad. And if you double clutch it, it doesn't do it as often. Really, when it's cold, it does it a lot. Like today, I started up the car for the first time in like 3 days, and it did it going in the third. It's not too bad. Like, it's not like a ferocious grind, but it's there, and you notice it.
Next thing I don't like is the rims on this thing. This is the stock rims, but they are so difficult to keep clean. It doesn't matter what you scrub them with or whatever, they always look dirty. I mean, obviously you can tell they are dirty, but it doesn't matter how much solution I put on this, how many times I clean it, they always look dirty. So hopefully, or most definitely, I'm gonna get new rims for it. I'm thinking about C7 replicas. They're kind of different. You don't usually see C7 replicas on the Trans Am. So I'm gonna probably go with those, but the stock rims are absolutely terrible. All right, the fourth thing that I'm kind of just sum up in all of it, because it surrounds the entire car, are all the imperfections in the paint. I got this car, it had peeling clear coat, and at the time I really didn't care about it, but now that I've had it for over a year, I really care about it, and it drives me insane. I don't know what GM did to make this paint just so shitty. I know I did, I actually started scraping off the paint with a razor, because it was just driving me nuts so much just to see that clear coat peeling, and it actually fucked up the paint even more. So I'm gonna have to do like a wet sand before I do like a wrap or anything, but see, like this, it's just nasty shit, and it drives me insane. You can see where I gouge into the paint doing it, so I have to do like a wet sand anyway, so it's no big deal. But pretty much whole way out around the car, the only part of the car that's really not ridiculous, like see even here, I don't know if you can see it that well, but is the right side. Like, the right side, it has it here, and like the front quarter, but then the rest of it isn't bad. And then I'm gonna add this in as well. I actually broke the clips off this side skirt here. A groundhog came out in front of me, and instead of ruining my front bumper, I kind of swerved and I actually clipped off the side of a road, and this thing is so low that it, you know, just kind of ripped that off. It's staying on. It just looks like shit. And then also there's imperfections here. I got ran into while I was at work. My car just got ran into. It was parked. Guy drove off. Couldn't find him. So I never got, you know, compensation for that. I could have took it to the body shop, but they wanted me to pay for basically everything. I had to put the $500 deductible down, and I was like, you know what, that should come out with a wet sand. I'm just not too worried about it. And final thing, I'm pretty sure this is number 5. I'm kind of doing these out of order, but is T-tops. You know, these cars are known for the T-tops. Pretty much every Trans Am has them, but I have not seen a Trans Am that does not have leaks. And it's not the T-tops themselves that leak. It is the, I guess you go like the weather stripping here. It kind of peels back, and water will get in here. It'll run out around here, and then it won't leak right away. But as soon as you like go downhill or something, all that water will run out and go straight down to my leg, and it'll come out and then go right down in the carpet in the back seat. So that's the 5 things I dislike. So I'm gonna move to the positives now. So since I got the 5 things I dislike, might as well start with the things I like, because I want to stay positive, right? So the first thing is I love the engine. This is a 5.7 LS1. It is the first generation of the LS, but it has just as many capabilities as any of the newer LSs. When GM came out with the LS, it's just a great engine. You have tons of aftermarket ability. there's tons of parts, and they're relatively cheap compared to, say an import or a German performance, so anything European. The parts are relatively cheap. It's just a modern overhead valve. I only had to worry about one cam. I don't have to worry about four cams or anything like that, like a Mustang would have to. Right now, I only have long tube headers on it. I have Texas Speed and Performance 1 3/4 long tube headers. I have this Volant ram air intake. The only reason I got this, I didn't want to be like the, you know, classic AutoZone Honda Civic owner, I guess, and just buy a cold air intake and think I'm gonna gain like 50 horsepower from it. The stock airbox in this thing looked absolutely hideous. It was just this big bulk of plastic. So I wanted something to make it more stand out, because, you know, obviously this is a great engine. But most people didn't notice that. They just noticed that big hunk of plastic right there that held the air filter. So I'm like, you know what? I want something that looks kind of aggressive. And really, when I open up the hood at like car shows, people are like, whoa, you know, that kind of looks badass. I wouldn't say, you know, adds a little bit of horsepower. I guess it might add a little bit. There's tons of myths and legends on what a cold air intake actually does, but it's whatever. I really just did it for the looks, because I usually have my hood up at a car meet, because just try to hide the imperfections from the hood, because that is peeling clear coat as well. I love about this car is the exhaust tone. Every one of my friends say it's loud as hell. It's not too bad. Like going down the highway in sixth gear, there's not much of a drone. It's more noticeable now in like my videos than it was when it was stock. Well, I say stock, but I got it had a Hooker catback system. But when I went ahead and put them long tubes on, it lightened it up a little bit. It's a little bit more throaty. I'll throw an exhaust clip in here right now. But anyways, I love the exhaust on it. I think the quad tips in the back look badass. But really, the exhaust setup is it's the two long tubes. It goes into a Y pipe that runs a single I pipe, just a single pipe down the middle. It goes up into a chamber muffler that the previous owner must have put on. And then just comes out into these two pipes. So it's not true dual exhaust. It's still basically single. But I do want to do a true dual system sooner or later, depending on how much horsepower I'm going to push, just to give it more breathing room. But for now, this works. It's kind of raspy because I went catless. But other than that, I love the exhaust note. All right, third thing I love about the car is still going in the looks, is the taillights. I think these taillights look so badass at night. Just the honeycombed, you can tell it's a Trans Am. I don't think I've ever seen any other taillights that look similar to this. My club president actually put a honeycomb vinyl wrap over his taillights on his Grand Prix, just to make them look like the Trans Am headlights. I mean, I love these. Like this one's broken. It was like that when I bought it. Still going over a lot of imperfections. It kind of sucks, but these are, I just love the taillights. Every picture I've seen of, you know, my friends behind me, they take a picture of the back. I think it looks so badass. And you have like the brake light up here on the wing. I think it looks badass. But with the taillights, I had actually my old Firebird. It's an actual sequential system. It kind of looks like the Mustang taillights. So when you hit the brake, the lights go out. Like four ways they go out. Just like a pattern, a sequential pattern. So that was just one of the first mods I've ever done to a car. I had it in my old Firebird. Basically, my old Firebird got totaled. My father, before they shipped it off, he cut the modules out of the old Firebird, and when we got this car, I just put them back in. But you can buy the kit. I don't even remember what website you bought them. I got it like 2 years ago. The kit, it's just like a sequential light kit. You can probably like go, just type in Google if you want like a sequential light kit. I think the company that makes them for like, makes them for like Trans Ams, even makes them for like the modern Camaros, even the two lights. Makes them from the Mustangs, for like older Mustangs that wasn't implemented then. But yeah, it's just a kit. Just so look up, if you really want it, just look up Trans Am Sequential Turn Signal Kit. And yeah, it should be the first link, honestly. And I think it was like $115. I mean, it's kind of pricey, but I mean, if you want to look, you get to look.
All right, moving back into the interior of the car. This is where we're going to end things I like. But one thing I love about this interior is the seats. Now, when I first got into this car, like a lot of modern cars, the seats feel really sporty. Like when you kind of sit them and they just suck you in, you know, kind of don't make you move. These are sporty, but they're kind of the opposite. I could honestly take a nap in these seats and not even have like a stiff back or anything. I feel like they're so comfortable, especially on like a long road trip. They're just nice. You know, you can just lean back and really just enjoy the drive. And I feel like a lot of the modern seats, they just kind of, since I'm a bigger guy, they kind of like squish you in a bit, and I kind of feel uncomfortable most of the time. But like in these, I guess they're just built for me. I guess they're built for a heavier set guy, but I love them. I mean, even my mother's, she has a Mazda CX-7, which is like a crossover SUV, and my back would start killing me after a long road trip in that thing. But this car, you know, I could probably go for a 4-hour road trip, and these seats would not start to bug me at all. I feel like they're just like a reclining chair. Like they're soft. I mean, they're leather. They have imperfections in them. There's a rip in here in the driver's side. It's not too bad. The previous owner tried to hide it and stitch it up. It looks like shit, but I like the seat. I probably won't ever get rid of the seats unless I really start building this car for racing and I want that extra support. Because you definitely do slide around a bit when you're going like kind of faster on turns. So it's not too, you know, I guess, sport, you know, enthusiastic, I guess. They're not too sporty oriented, I guess. But you got to think, this is like late 90s, early 2000s. That really wasn't too big of a deal in an American muscle car. I will move to the fifth and final thing that I like. And this is kind of hard because just the whole car as a whole. But if I want to think of one thing that I truly like about this car, is the clutch feel. It is unlike any other clutch I put in. This is not a stock clutch, but it is not heavy as people would think it would be. And then the clutch pedal, like, throw, I don't know if you can see it. I doubt it, honestly. But the throw is really long, and like I said before, this is the first car that I learned how to drive. I learned how to drive a manual because my old Firebird was an automatic. It took me one day to learn how to drive this car, and not even a day, a couple hours, because by the second day, I was ready to hop in and drive it. I was going to community college at the time, and I just wanted to drive it, but my father said no. But I did end up driving it to work that night. But it was so easy, and then the release point is really near the top. So it's kind of easy, you know, to get a good mix between, you know, your clutch and then the gas. So it's just really easy to do. But I think I'm going to end the video there. It was fun, you know, just to hang out, kind of relieve some stress after classes. It's Wednesday, is one of my longest days. But I'm going to link, really I want to challenge my friend Layton Cook. I'm going to link his channel in the description. His channel is growing amazingly fast, so I hope this will be able to give him content well. So Layton, do the five things you like, five things you dislike of either the Audi or the Nissan. I don't care which one you do, but it'll give you some content on your channel, so we'll kind of have the same thing going when you do the review. But other than that, guys, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I'm gonna try my hardest to finish out the day. Hope you like the new recording style. trying to make things a lot more steady for you guys. A lot of my car meet show or reviews or the car show showcases, as I like to call them, they're really jerky. They're with me walking. I'm trying to smooth that up. But other than that, I just hope you guys like the video. Like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what I need to improve on, because I am obviously not perfect at all. But car reviews are coming out soon. I might have one lined up next week. I'm going to try to get as many scheduled as possible. Like I said, Layton's Audi S4 or the Nissan might be getting reviewed here soon. A couple other friends of mine, they have a surprise vehicle. It is a Ford. It's not a Mustang, but it's going to be a surprise. But there's not many reviews out on them just yet. And also, they have a BMW M6 that I'd like to record. I'm not expecting them to let me review it full on. I'm probably going to allow them, you know, the owner, to be in the passenger seat with me, just so I don't, you know, get out of control, because that thing is basically a supercar. I mean, I trust myself. I mean, it is a $100,000 car. I mean, but I want to really get that. And then they also have a 335i. It's nothing too crazy. I mean, it's just a 335i. Just a 335i. But I want to get that underway. I might have a Lancer coming up, TC coming up. And then also in Motorama. Motorama is going to be a big event. It starts next weekend, which I bet your ass I'm definitely going to be recording. I'm going to be setting up, like, I guess, another surprise, really. It's going to be like a documentary-style thing on the car scene. But more importantly, focused on Midnight Customs Car Club. Which is going to be really fun. I'm really excited to do. I'm really excited to, you know, really talk to my club president, and just get a good idea of, you know, his opinion on the car scene. Because you guys, if you see my last video, you guys know my opinion on it. So, but yeah, other than that, I just, like I said, like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what I need to work on. But yeah, follow my Instagram. I'm going to link that. I have that posted in the outro, but I'm going to put a link to it in the description. I'm going to put a link to Layton's channel. You show him some support. He's got some great content coming out. And yeah, hope you guys have a wonderful day. I'll see you later.